Welcome to this introductory walkthrough of PrimeTime Draft Football. In this video, I'm going to show how quickly and easily you can set up and start drafting using PrimeTime Draft software. There will be other videos that go into more advanced topics, such as remote view, auto pick, trades keepers, auction drafts, etc. But this video is going to cover the basic snake draft. So, let's get started. The first thing you need to do is click the Create a New Draft button, name your draft, and click OK. What you see now is what we call the Draft Management screen. On this single screen, you will configure everything about your draft. You'll select how many teams are in your league, how many rounds your league drafts, the type of draft. We support all the most popular types, such as snake, auction, straight, third round reversal, and we also have a manual mode for leagues that use a non-standard draft format. I'm going to leave it on snake. This time limit setting lets you set the maximum amount of time a person should take to make a pick. I say should because when this limit is hit, we don't force a pick or automatically move the clock to the next person if a pick is not made within the time limit. But we do blare a horn and turn the clock red so that everybody knows that someone has taken too long and that everybody needs to start hassling them about taking too long. Clock direction, up or down. Some people want the clock to count up. Some people want it to count down. So select whichever you prefer. We support IDP, so if your league drafts individual defensive players, you'd change this to yes. We have a text-to-voice feature that will audibly announce each selection as it's made. Some people want to show bye weeks on the draft board, others don't, so we support either way. And here is where you would enable remote view, which is our free web service for people who can't be at the draft party location but do have access to the internet. Remote view allows them to view the draft board and even draft their own players using a web browser. Remote view will be the subject of its own separate video. Over here, we have the team names and draft order. You can highlight these default team names and change them to the names of the teams in your league. And you can easily drag and drop the teams to change the draft order. Once you have everything set up, it's time to start drafting. Click the Start Draft button. We're now viewing the draft board. The first time you enter this screen for a draft, you'll be shown this help box, which explains how to add players, remove players, change the clock position, etc. So, let's click OK to get rid of this box and start drafting. As you can see, the draft has begun and the first team is on the clock. When the team who is on the clock decides on their pick, click on the clock to add their selection to the draft board. In this dialog box, we give you various ways to find players to add to the board. We have these filters here that let you narrow down the list by position and/or team, and the sort by option so you can control the order that the results are shown. But the easiest way to find a player is to just start typing the player's name in our smart search field. Let's say the first team wants to take Adrian Peterson. Start typing his first or last name, and you'll be shown a list of players that match what you've typed in. As you can see, just by typing an A, I've already found Adrian Peterson at the top of the list of available players. If I continue typing more of his name, the list will get smaller and smaller. But because we sort the list by rank, often it's only necessary to type a couple of letters to find the player you're looking for. When you click on Adrian Peterson, you'll get this nice preview so you can confirm the selection before you click the OK button to add the pick to the board. The clock automatically moves to the next team, based on the type of draft you're doing. Let's say the second team wants to take Jamal Charles. I'll click on the clock, type J, and there he is right at the top of the list. Click him, click OK, and he's on the board. It's that quick and easy. And you would just keep adding players to the draft board like this until your draft is complete. But let's say, for whatever reason, you need to remove a player from the board. No problem. All you have to do is click on the player and confirm that you want to remove the pick by clicking Yes. The player is removed from the board and added back into the pool of available players. If you want to change the team that is on the clock, just click the slot you want to move the clock to. At any time, you can click the Back button to go back to the Draft Management screen. Notice that the number of teams and rounds are locked, since the draft is in progress, but all the other settings could be changed at any time. So there you have it. PrimeTime Draft is that quick and easy to use. If you want to try it for yourself, you can download our free trial version at www.primetimedraft.com. And be sure to check back often for more videos covering various other topics. Thanks for watching.